There we go. Where was I? Oh, yes. Welcome to VR Fridays. For anyone that's lurking in chat that just happened to join, welcome. We are once again playing Project Wingman. I'm just in the process of getting everything set up here. Happy Friday. Yeah, the weather is looking great for once. Over here.
Nice and warm, baby.
Been a little too warm. Around 85 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know how to convert that into Celsius. So you have to take my word for it that it is smoking, especially in my room here where our air conditioning has yet to kick on and running a hot VR headset. Yeah, it's a recipe for disaster. That's not good. Let's turn this baby on really quick. Cool. 3 bars. I can do with it. You don't want to overcharge your Valve Index controllers, which is the setup I'm using. Just doing some audio testing here really quick. Game audio looks around decent. I just need to make sure that I can be. Oh. That game is really loud, isn't it? At least the background music. As for my own voice, it seems to be slightly above. Let's raise it a little bit. How about now? All right, good. Hitting at straight yellow bars. Not higher than yellow, not higher than mid yellow. Game music is about around the same level or so. That's really reduced just a little bit. There we go. Okay, I think that's good. I think we're good now. Maybe. Awesome. That's enough fucking around. Let's get to flying, huh? At least try and get past the Bloody Ocean mission first, which we were stuck on at the end of last session. Just to let y'all know, I cannot easily check chat while playing at the same time, so I will be checking chat periodically after missions. Occasionally, I will pause every now and then to see what's going on in chat, see what y'all are talking about behind my back. I'm using a PNG tuber today because this game already stresses my hardware enough as it is. And trying to run this game on also VC Face at the same time is not happening. Oh, I just remembered. Definitely need to turn that on as well. I had to turn on Streamlabs stream labels so it can update my followers, subscribers, etc. in real time. Going to also go ahead and. Nah, let's just go get straight into it. Think we spent enough time preparing as it is, don't you say? Here we go. Prepare for liftoff.
Tarkin Comic. You're the only mercenary pilots on base at the moment, so this is your mission effective immediately. A few hours ago, the remnants of Cascadia's Coast Guard was able to board and raid a Federation battleship which ran a little too close to Cascadia's northern coasts. They have promptly christened it as the Eminent Domain. The Eminent Domain is a new battleship used by the Federation Navy. Equipped with top-of-the-line armament and an electronic warfare suite, it stuffs most of the utility of an entire battle group into its hull. The Independence Force are deploying resupply and escort ships to them ASAP, however, they need air support. We have the means to repair it and gain intelligence from disseminating whatever info we can from its computers, but it is imperative that it is escorted to safe harbor first. Hitman, take off immediately. Dismissed.
Less.
I'm a mercenary. I still end up. Come on, Monarch. Let's go.
You know, it's funny. Last time I was playing this, I was flying the F4FEs. And I probably should have been flying my bread and butter, the F-14. Why, you may ask? F-14s are carrier-based jets. They are meant for this sort of combat. Fell in love with the F-14 back when I played the original Top Gun for the PlayStation. Usually I fly F-15s and F-22s, but there's always a special place in my heart for the F-14 for that reason. Let me just double check my knowledge of the controls, because I do have a tendency to forget these things very easily. Yaw left and right, throttle up and down, pitch, roll. Look side to side. Now then, shoot missile. Change view of the where I'm facing in the game. Centered view. Change target V. R for map. Change camera. I'm not going to do that anymore. Weapon cycle. Pretty sure weapon cycle is supposed to be tab, but for whatever reason it's not doing that, so I have to just learn the 1, 2, 3, 4s. Oh, that's probably weapon cycle right there. Okay. Without further ado, let's get going. I think I was supposed to actually purchase the Harrier before playing this level, because it was for sale. But I was just short of about 1,000 credits or so, so I couldn't buy it. Which became a real thorn in the side, let me tell you. No matter. We'll have to make do. Here we go. Shit, man. 2,000. Can I, like, sell one of my old craft here? Cannot be sold. Cannot be sold. Sell price, 5,100. Do I dare? Response rating, 2.2. Max speed, 2,500. Acceleration, 75. Roll rate, 200. Turn rate, 100. Yaw rate, 12. I don't know what the fuck any of that means. Special weapons list. S standard missiles, several anti-ground missiles, URS, URM, unguided bombs. I'm assuming these don't mean unguided. Those are probably... Oh, those might be unguided rockets. The hell is... I'm guessing MGP means machine gun missile. Notably, there are no options here for... anti-air missiles. These are all anti-ground. Not really sure my odds on that, you know. I might be better off just trying to make do with these guys. Let's try flying an F-14, like I said I was going to. First First slot, weapons list. HVSMs. High velocity standard missiles. But half the damage of standards. But at least I'll waste less time using these. These are better for killing ships. Multi-lock anti-airs. But only if you get the drop on someone is the problem. And lastly, do we even want to bother with bombs this time? I don't really want to be honest. Unless I get the ones with large explosive radius, but you only get 8 of those. We'll need to get around to buying additional missile specials at some point. You know what? Fuck it. More missiles. Because what do we need? I don't think I'll be using the anti-ground weapons for this mission. You would think that I'd need to deal with the ships, but I've been able to take them out just fine with regular missiles. Trying to take them out with bombs is causing me problems. I think I got myself killed more times that way than otherwise. Alright. Let's do it. Wish me luck. You insist.
This is resupply ship court. We remain on station for the eminent domain to link up with us. Roger all. High rating Federation ships now. Hitman, sink any and all contacts in the area before eminent domain gets here.
Let's take out the fighters first. Get them out of my way. Hit. Beautiful. This one got away. Looks like my first victim. Where'd you go? Nah, fuck that. Pick out the fighter first. Dodge that, motherfucker. And you're dead. Switching to standard missiles. These guys are closer. There's a bug eye up there. Take that one out first. Blind the defenders. Oh man, railguns. We got railguns. Goodbye. You're still alive? Not anymore, you're not. Oh shit. Yeah, they are not happy. Got dodge this. Oh, good job. You actually dodged this. Son of a bitch. Come on, come on. Damn. These G-forces, though. Honey, you should deal with yourself first. Altitude is at 10,000 feet. At least I don't need to worry about crashing into the sea anytime soon. Ah, shit. Where did that missile come from? Was that even a missile? Sam's. It's from the sea. Oh, shit. Ah, that is not nice. I do not like you guys. I got hit by another one of you. Oh shit. Yeah, I forget which one is the flares. This one is F. Wait, no. No, it's not F. Shit. Which one of these ones is the flares? I've been pushing the wrong button for flares this whole time. Gun. Change target. Map. Oh! Why am I holding onto the mouse? You don't. That's why I was getting confused there. It's one of these things, isn't it? H. I feel dumb. Alright. Well, I'm probably gonna die now. I've only got 8 health, but let's see how far we can go. Missiles away. I actually did pretty well that time. Come on, baby. Oh, shit. Oh. Woo! This guy is a slippery motherfucker. Got you. Alright, time to take out these battle cruisers because that's starting to piss me off. Really? Didn't. Damn. My hull only has 1 health left. I'm not even supposed to be alive right now. Hey, how wild would it be if I actually somehow beat this level with one health? I should get an achievement for that. It's not gonna happen, but... Dodge this, motherfucker! Unfortunately, he did manage to dodge that. Shit. Now that we have remembered how to use flares, we will have to do this properly. I should probably announce on Twitter that I'm actually streaming. Second here, Jack. Am I sweating already? One of these days, I gotta try playing this game with, like, actual joysticks. Gladly. What the fuck? Oh shit, we are above the clouds. Got you. Switch to standards. Go for starting our bombing run now. Man, is it just me, or is the cockpit for the F-14 a lot more claustrophobic? Goodbye. Intercept group, be advised. We are contending with ASM planes as of current day. Take out that Oh shit. Oh man. Got to target those rail guns. Not sure what happened there. Are we still alive? We are. Got you. Ow, 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 ow. Which one is just gonna hit? One of them did. That's good. There you are. Almost there. Come on. Got you. Cool. Woo! That was close. Ow, shit. What the hell hit me? Bad, 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 bad. 45 health. I'm not sure we're gonna be able to do this, but we will try. Another bug eye in the sky. I didn't check this research this beforehand, but I got the impression that these support craft actually help the enemies that you're fighting find you and shoot you. I mean, that's kind of their job, right? In previous games, I didn't have nearly this much trouble getting shot by AA and railguns. So I figure, why not take them out? It's like shooting fish in a barrel. Incoming missiles. Not anymore, ain't. Missed? From that distance? How? Come on, missiles, fire, fire. I probably shouldn't try to be in a rush in this game. But I don't want to get killed.
Mama, it's a shot.
Confirmed kill. Ow. Felt that one in my soul just now.
Ground unit destroyed.
More like a C unit. Too close to the ground? How do you keep missing, my guy? Try dodging that. Oh. You're shooting my missiles out of the air. Is that how it is? I see now. That actually makes a lot of sense. That is an advantage of having unguided bombs as opposed to missiles. Confirmed kill. There you are. Awesome. All units destroyed. Those ships? I'll show you an ideal. How are them apples? No, you don't. Damn right I am. Shit, I'm getting way too close to the water. Gotta keep track of my altitude. Barely can't see anything though. Got you. No, you won't. You be prepared to be disappointed, my dude. Oh shit, really? Out of STM. Fine. Losing way too much altitude just then. F-14 is holding together still, I think. Dodge that. Got you. Shit. Pushing that button. I need to rebind that to somewhere else. Because otherwise, it's just gonna keep happening.
I'm engaging.
slowly but surely wins the race. Come on. Please hit. Yes! Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Just one aircraft left. Comic got him. Thanks, Comic. Oh shit. They could take out one of the missiles, but not all of them. That's how we do it. Coming in hard. Oh shit. Okay. Both missed? Shit, really? Bruh, those rail guns are something else. Will I get him? Yes. I'm gonna go assassinate these ships over here really quick. How? I'm trying, Prez, I'm trying. I can only do so much, you know. Shit, man. Wasting so much missiles, just sending them into the sea. Comic, you gotta help me out here. Going in for another pass. Hevlock and fire. Confirmed kill. Ah! Scratch the paint job. Getting a little closer to the ground, too. And we got a confirmed kill. Now let's go for our next rest of these guys. Woo! 55 missiles, can we do it? I can't use the others because those are only strictly anti-air. Well, you're not going to be able to. Not when I'm done with you. Might actually win this, but I hope I don't jinx it. Damn it. That was a miss. Woo! Let's finish, let's clean up the rest of these now. Really? Try dodging that. A little too low to the ground. Fox 2, Fox 2. Hit! Someone put way too much dexterity on these ships. Fine, we'll go up. Go ahead and finish this one off then. Have these ships over here down first. If I didn't know better, I'd say that these ships are actually retreating. They've more or less been castrated of all of their anti-ship weapons. All they got is AA, and for some reason, I cannot hit them. Try it again. Going in for another pass. Let's try and not get ourselves killed.
Right on target.
29 missiles, let's go. Cool. What the fuck? Oh, you've got to be fucking kidding me. We'll see about that. Where are they coming from? Oh shit. Really? Where are they? Come on, where are they? From the sunlight? MLAs are locked and loaded. A good thing I saved some of these. But I don't see the cruise missiles. Oh, now I see them. Chonky motherfuckers. Soon to be dead, motherfuckers. Dodge this! Oh, that was actually pretty good. What the fuck? Okay, this is some Ace Combat bullshit. Woo! Good shooting, Comic. That's a lot of cruise missiles. Awesome. That is not a cruise missile, that is a jet fighter. And you're soon to be dead on top of that. Oh, hello there. Confirmed kill. Enemy craft shot down. How many more of you fuckers are there? Oh my god. I'm gonna run out of missiles at this rate. Okay. Just you left, buddy. I need to get in close. I'm almost out of ammunition. Can't afford to use missiles on the last jet. Need to use them to take out these cruise missiles, or I'm screwed. Oh, no, 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 no. You are not hitting that. I am not replaying this mission again just because of this. Fuck off. Looks like one of them actually managed to hit, too. Is this the last one? Oh, ho, I'm... silly me, I still had some LLAAs. Gotta slow down, otherwise we won't be able to hit it. Come on. Fuck off! Yes. Woo! Oh my fucking god, I was so close to losing this mission. Down to my last fucking missile. Alright, okay, how do I RTB? Okay.
The Humane has made it to Allied waters safe and sound. Its repair and refit will ensure that we have the advantage near the coasts and at sea as long as it's afloat. Captain Woodward extends his regards and has forwarded you some items he has recovered from the former captain's quarters, most chiefly a bottle of whiskey. Stand by for your next sortie.
That kind of burned me out, chat. Holy shit. Clear skies.
One of the vast advantages that the Federation has over Cascadia is their absolute control and logistics routes. Factories and states that we can't even touch are pumping out equipment and supplies for them at a pace we'll never be able to match. However, they all have to get in the country somehow. The Federation supply train is one carried out mostly by air, now that the eminent domain is intercepting cargo ships coming into Federation ports. Civilian traffic has remained largely the same thanks to Federation communication protocols. The reality of this conflict has been kept hidden, courtesy of the Solana communication facility in the Aitor Desert. This mission is as follows. Mercenary and allied pilots will be dispatched to various points along the airways, knocking out Federation logistics aircraft and grinding their resupply efforts to a halt. By striking in broad daylight, we can openly challenge the Federation when they think they're safe. Remember, it's imperative that no civilians are harmed in this operation, so engage carefully.
Careful is my last name, and safety's my mom. Let's go, Monarch. I'd like to touch down before lunch.
You could tell that guy fucks. Hey, Lenarth. Have a good night. Thanks for stopping by. The F-18. And a Su-27, it looks like. Multi-row fighters. I think this one's gonna be mostly aircraft, though. An old MiG-21. This one has fixed, looks sort of like a griffin. An F-16, for sure, is what this is. No idea what this big motherfucker is. Looks like a supersonic jet, judging from the nose cone. Max speed 3500? Yeah, definitely is. Did I unlock new crafts? I don't recognize some of these things. What ships to use? So many choices. I'm actually at a loss, to be honest, of what to fly next. Why mess with a good thing? Really wish I could buy new weapons, though. I'm surprised you can't. Oh, I see. High damage, high tracking capability, anti-air weapon, but you must remain painted by a pilot for usage. I could deal with that. Give that to me. Some multi-locks. Some more multi-locks. Gonna be going mostly with... Gonna be going mostly with... anti-air stuff this time. I can't help but feel like there's a shop somewhere that I'm missing. Let's see if we can find it. Just doesn't it seem strange that they have all these options, but I can't really do anything with them? These are just pilot entries, though. Let's look around a little bit. Man, it's getting hot in here too. Maybe I was wrong. Guess there isn't an option for that stuff after all. Prepare for launch. Yep.
Talk to me when you start piloting, Prez. Don't tell me you're not riding coattails.
Piss off, you yuppie.
7 enemy target convoys tagged. Engage with caution.
Hey, we've got 2 military jets off of our 4 o'clock. What gives?
You see the amount of military on board here today? Escorts probably.
It's all lined up.
Stacked up. Bingo.
Bingo boingo. Closing in for the kill. Let's try out our new missiles.
I've got a gun tone.
Really? Too close, I guess? shit, this is hard to control. Got you. Yeah, no kidding, right?
Escorts are vectoring into engage. Pull past them and hit those transports, Hitman 1.
Oh, man. They're too close. I can't use MLAs. But I could use them on these. I hope they get me a good spot. Oh, really?
I got the head for one AWACS up here.
F-15s, though. That's gonna be a pain.
This needle as best we can.
Come on. You slippery motherfucker. Oh my god. Everything. Spam rams, I love that. I have decided I do not like the SAAs. Oh boy. Take out the AWACS up there first. Another AWACS, huh? Slowly but surely wins the race. Three missiles, what the fuck? Oh my goodness, that is a lot of... That's a lot of them. Uh, SK-27. How many of these do I have left? Just one? Got to make a count. Have you now? These G-forces would kill a man. Thankfully, I'm not a man. Nice. On.
Monarch Fox 2.
Got you. How many are left? No, I see.
Hitman 1 locked on.
Bird to kill. This is a lot easier in the ship stage, that's for damn sure. Come on, come on. Got you. Oh, man. Why do you have a German accent? Did I get him? Hull integrity is at 53%. Oh, I did get one of them. Flying F-15s, no less. Good thing I saved so many of these. Got you. Relax, 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 relax. Wait for the chance. Slimy bastard. Got him. It's now just time for to kill the big bird. Gotta wait for the missiles to reload and we'll come in for the final kill. Oh shit. 20% health. Take this, motherfucker. All right. Come on. I need you guys to reload faster. Come on. Just one more hit should do it.
Spam rams out.
How much ammo do I have left? Not much? Great. That's just what I needed. Come on. Three left? Shit. Okay. Fine. Three left. We could do three. Come on. Rearm. Come on. Okay. Woo! Oh my god. Hands sweaty. Knees deep. Palms sweat. Out of those.
Clear. Good job today,
oh, I killed him.
Before anyone else shows up.
my god. You're welcome. God damn, in a fight.
The intercept operation was a success. Worldwide, news is breaking out about the Independence Force's calculated and precise presence on the international stage. No civilian casualties have been reported. Federation, while dealing with the disruption of their airtrain, have to contend with international response to the war. Hitman 1, your flight was the most successful of these intercepts, and the Federation is currently scrambling to find alternative ways to maintain logistics.
That's good to know.
Monarch, this is an op just for you.
Oh, really?
You know I don't like admitting this, but mercenary pilots in this world are among some of the best. They get more airtime, more time on target, than any of us national pilots outside of the periphery. In truth, you get the glamour we all thought fighter pilots were supposed to have when signing up to the Academy. That, you're making five times what I make in a year. I wonder if that's why you went private, but I don't think you're the type to give that answer. Not to me, anyway. What I'm trying to say is, you're capable. More capable than most, getting this far in. And because of that, we need you on deck for a one-man mission.
Cascadia's southeastern deserts hosts the Solana Communication Array. It was a Federation and Cascadian telecom venture meant to expand Cascadia's networking capability, regardless of any thermal interference that traditionally plagues long-range communications. With that facility, communications between various Federation units are streamlined, while limiting jamming and interrupting our own. Nothing to say of the censorship abilities that are used to enforce the civilian information flow. This is one of the Independence Force's top targets, however, it's been outside our strike range until now. Due to its distance from our front lines, no fuel can be wasted dodging or circumventing Federation anti-air systems en route. In short, we're sending you alone to clear up the most disruptive defense systems before we engage in a full-scale operation to knock out the facility. You will insert into the Kaohord defense region in the Raver Mountains and take out all critical defense systems under cover of night. The defense system is calibrated for mass aerial strikes, but a lone aircraft flying relatively level with the mountains should be able to slip through and take them out. Dismissed.
I'm ready to tell her this mission's gonna be a pain in the ass. Always is in Ace Combat. Hey, Millie. Sorry, I only just responded now. I can't respond when I'm in the midst of the gameplay. I hope you didn't leave in the past 15 minutes. I'm doing pretty well. It's Friday. It's very hot outside. I'm streaming Project Wingman. What about you? How you doing? Let me take a break anyway.
Oh my god. Oh my god, oh my god. I'm kind of... my eye's starting to hurt, actually.
It's alright. I can shake it off.
Let me get a drink of water, though, in the meantime. Check my messages on TweetSpace and all that good stuff before I head over That's weird. I got another message from Sad Support. Some good news online, it looks like. Should make a mental note to check chat every few seconds, maybe. Or find a way to play chat while inside so that I can respond in real time while flying. Even though you're not supposed to, you know, text and drive. We can make an exception for this game, right? Am I starting to sweat in meat space? Disgusting. I can't believe we're actually playing this on mercenary mode right now. Or is it hard mode? I can't remember. We're playing it on one of the harder ones, that's for sure. This is definitely ground-based mission, so we should equip some ground attackers. An F-15 fighter. Acceptable loss. What can I afford to buy now? The F-15 is specifically a anti-air fighter, though. It's curious, I still don't know where to purchase new weapons. I thought that the option would have appeared by now, you know?
see now. Multi-lock-on, anti-ground, unguided bombs, unguided rocket missiles. Wonder what what this one stands for. SR? SA? Wish we could buy these stuff separately. Like, I don't even know where you're supposed to find those. It feels like I'm missing something, but I can't figure out what it is I'm missing. There we go. What are we going to do with you? Let's grab the F-15. Good buddy. Gun pod, that's what that is? Dumb. There we go, this is the good shit right here. Let's do it. This is not going to be comfy, unlike anti-ground missions. They're always a pain in the ass. We'll try to do it quick.
Monarch, the radar defenses are pretty hidden away on the mountain range, but your pal Galaxy got them all marked out. After this mission, don't tell me I never do anything for you.
Yeah, let's go with that.
Missile away. Enemy on radar.
Bombs away.
Right on target.
Beautiful. It's a beautiful night out tonight, though.
You know, Monarch, I've heard a lot about why you three joined. Hitman, that is. Comic had her wings clipped, Dip was told he wasn't good enough to fly out of the Academy, and you came in with him. My question, though, is what are you all looking for after all this time? You've made your fortunes and lost them so many times these last few years. So what else is there?
Huh. Someone's getting a little talkative anyway. Shit.
Do you guys actually like each other or what? Fox two. Hitman one, missile tracking, evade. It's a single fighter. Two dark division of red team. Shut down. Monarch, the enemy's locking onto you.
How much ammo do I have left? Not much. Shit.
Monarch, the enemy's locking onto you.
Yes, I'm aware.
Peacekeepers spoke about a pilot like this. It might be him up there. Missile away! On my 6!
And on your 12 as well. Who goes there?
Oh,
You want me to fly an F-16? F-15's base, you packing JDAMs or AGMs, rifle, Fox 2, guns, 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 not much ammo left, 23, shh, it's a lot. 23 rounds of gun ammo, anyway. I'm always worried about me running out of AGMs, is the problem. I'm sorry I didn't respond to you sooner, by the way, it's because I don't have a way of checking chat while in flight. If I had seen that you were talking about the F-16 earlier, I would have totally chosen it just for you. Sorry about that. How are you doing today, Mika? Welcome to the stream. And also, thank you for the follow. I mean, I can see chat in VR, but only if I push the home key on my index controller. Otherwise, all I see is just the game itself. And I kind of get really immersed in fighting game in a jet simulator, so. Oh, I see. That makes sense. Are you actually in the Air Force, or do you just like flying the F-16 in Sims? Me, I'm actually an F-15 nut. That's part of the reason why I chose the F-15, even though there are probably better attack rounds. Oh, just Sims? Yeah, same here. Well, welcome to the stream. Welcome to the stream. I think I've seen you around, but I'm gonna go ahead and say my spiel anyway. I'm Lawler Hicks. I'm a shitposting artificial intelligence from a text board. I play virtual reality games on Fridays, and that's why we're playing Project Wingman right now. I didn't realize the F-15 actually has a great record for ground attack, too. I thought they were mostly fighter interceptors. But that's good to know. Another reason to love F-15s, right? Let me stretch a little bit here. Hey, Chris. How are you today? Welcome to the stream. We are playing Project Wingman. In VR, no less. That's why it's shaking around so much. I heard a follow sign, so I paused a little bit to see who was in chat. Just talking with Mika here, who just followed me. Thanks again. And I'm going to get back into it in just a second. F-15 and 16 were built for air-air. But the air-air role requirements on air-ground ones are very similar. Thrust, payload, ECM, and maneuverability. Very good point. Very good point. I guess there aren't that many aircraft these days that are built for very specific roles anyway, like the A-10 being a almost purely ground attack vehicle. I think the F-22 is an air superiority fighter specifically, right? I could be wrong, though. I know some of them. That's why I figured. At least in all the literature I've read about, F-22 always seemed like it was supposed to be a air superiority specific craft. And then they made the F-35, which they're trying to make a multi-role vehicle also, but then all the drama started happening with like bloat and stuff. Assuming our F-35s take off without crashing anyway. When I was a kid, I was actually an Air Force hopeful. My eyes are kind of garbage though, and most of the U.S. Air Force is starting to switch to drones anyway, so. Well, maybe not all of it, but they're doing a lot of sequestering, or they were at one point. Brrr. Honestly, I'm glad that flight simulators or simulator likes are still a thing in current year. You know, with the Ace Combat series and now with Project Wingman and some other games. And I saw that Gargura had just played Project Wingman recently on her stream. So I guess there's a renewed interest in these sort of games now. Well, it's a funny story. Last week, my Project Wingman stream ended up being the most viewed VOD that I had so far. I didn't realize so many people liked this game. Flight seems to be taking off. IL2 has good popularity, same with DCS. That's good to know. Alright. I'm gonna pop back in the cockpit for a little bit. I'll check chat again in around 10 or 15 minutes. Believe it or not, I am actually one of the original backers of Star Citizen, but I've not played it in a little bit. I'll need to reinstall it to my rig and check it out. I have Elite Dangerous, but I haven't played that in a little bit either. I also played, some indie. Thank you for the follow, Ringo Kraito Kingu. I'm Lawler Hicks. I'm shitposting Artificial Intelligence and, Jet Pilot, I can't fucking talk right now. Jet Pilot, Moonlighter. How are you doing tonight? Happy Friday. I actually don't know many other sim VTubers. The only other sim VTubers I know is someone who plays a lot of racing sims and another person who plays a lot of MechWarrior. So it's good to know that I didn't realize that there were other jet flight simulator players as well. Kita VT? That's cool. I'll have to check them out sometime. What was I saying? I played a lot of Evercron Mercenary when I was new, and a lot of games that are also by the same dev for pretty much take place in the same universe. A cheetah pilot, huh? Kita VT. I wonder if he watched a lot of, what's the name of that one TV show that came out, that used to be out, about a pair of cats who flew a high, super modded up F-15? Air Force Cats or something? Cat Force? I forgot the name of it. I used to really love that show as a kid. It should ring a bell because it was a fairly popular cartoon at the time, back in the 90s. But for love of me, I literally cannot remember the name of it right now. There are too few flight simulator streamers because of how taxing flight simulator is. That's a good point. Not to mention, I'm playing this in VR right now, and usually when I play VR, I'm standing and running around, so doing VR while sitting down is actually really fatiguing for me, especially since it's been pretty cold for summer for the past month or two. But now, today, it's like 85 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know what that is in Celsius, but rest assured, it's fairly hot in my room right now. In between my VR headset and my head, my graphics card running at full speed, and also our air conditioning hasn't kicked in, so I'm actually burning up. Speed. Speed. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and jump back into the battle. I will check in again in a few minutes. Feel free to continue talking amongst yourselves, and if you have any questions or want to comment on anything, I will get to it as soon as I am able. I also really appreciate clips if you see me do anything or say anything stupid. 86 degrees Fahrenheit? Oh shit, I'm sorry. Oh, a normal person's PC would be burning up? That's a good point. My 1080 Ti even is starting to kind of chop up. I can't even use my normal avatar right now. I have to use a PNG tuner for the moment because otherwise I would slow to a standstill. And it's raining, huh? Shit, man, I'm sorry. Alright, alright. Let me find the controls again and resume flight. What were we doing? Oh yes. I'm trying to save ammunition for the priority targets. Let's yaw a bit there. Prepare the M-lags, and let's get rolling. I see aircraft in the distance. Let's pop these C-rams first, and then I'll target the aircraft next.
Good tone.
And they both missed. What gives? I got no visuals on my end. Fire them again and see what happens. Shit, one of them missed again. Oh, that was not a good noise. Alright. Gotta conserve those, and the other one... Oh, you son of a bitch! That's why. Take that, though.
Target down.
Are those helicopters? They're holding position, so they must be. Let's see if I can spook them. Fly really close to the ground here, and we are going to... Goodbye! Whoa, I can fire 6 of these at a time now? Based. I love the F-15. I love the sound of dead aircraft in the morning. Kinda getting close. Close enough that they can't shoot these out of the sky before they hit. Visually confirm the deaths of those SAMs. It's gonna take us a while to reload, though. At least it's a nice night tonight, right? Okay, bae. Come on. Oh. That was dumb.
Radar lock.
Awesome. Woo, that lightning bolt was right next to us. I see you there. Where'd these guys come from? F-14s? Child's play. Or it should be. Oh, this could be bad.
Ground target destroyed. Keep them guessing.
Oh, what the fuck? So I don't know what happened there. That was a waste of missiles. Got you. Scratched my paint job. Thanks for nothing, buddy. Come on. Oh, shit. Should've waited. How many jets are up here? Too many, that's how many. We're good, Galaxy, we're good. Don't worry about me. Man, that F-14 tanked those missiles like a boss. It's not gonna tank this one, though. He'll just evade instead.
Monarch miss a shot.
Got you.
Guns, guns, guns.
Guns, guns, guns. Speaking of guns, need to get back to work. Alright, we are in rain. Nope, I don't see him. I don't see him yet. They're on the other side of this mountain. Wait, what the fuck? I lost lock. Now I regain lock. Ow, 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 ow. Ow. Rude! Man, even with flares, he couldn't dodge that. What's that say about him? Nothing good, that's what. Ow, ow, ow. Come on.
You're in gun range.
Ah, shit. Chewie is not going to be happy. So glad I got the guided missiles, because this mission would have been such a pain in the ass otherwise. Awesome. How many I got left? Oh, I only got 4 of these left. Great. Gotta make them count. Don't tell me that's the only one I have left. Ah, shit. Not looking good. Twenty-4 health left. Here's hoping I could still make it. Yes, yes, I'm aware. Gotta get a clear shot, though. Ow. I cringe every time I take damage. It's a nervous tick. That's a lot of jets. Wait, what the fuck is that? Why is that a priority target? Oh, that's why. It's an AWACS. And it's a dead wax.
Enemy
Come on.
Ground unit destroyed.
How much more of this do we have left? Just one, right? Looks like it. Goodbye. And it misses. Why am I not surprised? Ow! Ow, 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 ow. Coming in for another attack run. Fox 2, Fox 2. Woo!
That's one for the books.
Made it.
Especially after what you pulled off tonight, single-handedly. Though that was one hell of a thing you did. And I got a feeling Operation Blackout will need you on point. We have a straight shot to Cascadia Southeast. And, with any luck, we'll have fuel to spare for the fight. Sicario is mobilizing en masse tomorrow morning. Get some sleep. This war isn't gonna win itself.
This is a long game?
There's nothing much I need to say to you, Sicario. Operation Blackout will be conducted entirely by you. I cannot, however, express enough how important this strike is. Commander, you have the floor.
The Aitor Desert has hosted the Solana Communication Array for the greater part of the decade. It was a Federation project in-country that was meant to boost and maintain the communications infrastructure of Cascadia. However, during the war, it has served as a jamming and communication facility. The very basis of a unified command structure is built on the pillars of communication. If we take out this facility, it'll be like yanking the rug out right from beneath their feet. The facility is heavily defended, hosting an airbase and a ground garrison on its own. The only way we're getting boots on the ground is via a mass airdrop, followed by relentless close air support from our fighter group until the entire place is overrun. It's as simple as that. Now normally, the Independence Force would be offering some assistance, but they can't afford that now. Under any other pretense, this is a suicide mission. Even with the air corridor Monarch cleared up, there's only enough fuel for a one-way trip. So the
oh my god.
We're coming back is if we take the adjoining airbase after we hit the facility. Expect heavy air and ground resistance. Pillboxes, tanks, AA, airships, the whole shebang.
Great.
Pull this off. Well, let's just say we'll be handsomely rewarded. Gold or glory, gentlemen. Get to your planes. The Cascadians call this place the Devil's Sandbox. So what does that mean if we're the ones playing in it, huh?
It means I'm about to stress the fuck out. Reading over chat now. By hyperfocusing in a random try on City's Skylands party and spent 6 hours playing Jumping Lunch? Holy shit! Why did you... Well, you said it's Skylands party, so I'm assuming you played with other people, right? Hmm. Nah? Let's get started. Let's get rolling, Raiders. We are playing on Mercenary mode, right? We're playing, well, whatever it is. We're playing in the one that can't be selected anymore. What did they unlock this time? Oh. I didn't unlock any new planes this time. Still have the good old stuff? Give me my MLAAs. Give me the... I don't really care for the semi-actives, actually. More MLAA. I don't like how they set up the buy system in this. They keep teasing you with all these color schemes and stuff, but I can't figure out how to actually use them. Or how you earn them. There's only one module so far in this whole game, it's Flares. I have a feeling like the game's just gonna have a massive change where suddenly the entire gameplay and everything you thought you knew about jets just like changes. But I didn't look up any spoilers for this. I even avoided watching the Maxor TV review. Oh man.
I wish I could say the same.
I'm dumb. I should have brought the bombs with me. Why didn't I bring bombs with me? Back to the hangar bay. Alright, let's do that again. There we go. As we were saying.
Galaxy and all Sicario elements, we're go for Operation Blackout. Total destruction of the enemy communication facilities are our prime objective for this operation. Cover Circus and destroy any base defenses before they deliver the ground forces to the DZ.
This is the largest deployment in our history as a mercenary group. The Independence Force put a lot of faith in us for this operation. Let's not disappoint.
So I guess that also means we're dead, right? I wish I could say the same. Monarch, good luck. Okay, all flights. Looks like the enemy defenses aren't the only issue now. Bogies inbound from the north toward our transports. That means you, Hitman. Intercept and engage.
Back off, Galaxy. We're going.
Now time. Comic engaging.
Confirmed rebel forces crossing into our airspace. I've got a visual on a non-uniform flight formation and transport aircraft.
I don't see any. Oh.
Stacked up.
Now I do.
Calling the other defense squadrons for patrol. Do not let them deploy ground forces.
1-3-1-3.
Outbound personnel, stand up. Stand up. Look up.
Well, that was easy. I can't help but feel like this mission is the turning point in the game, where something horrible is gonna happen. Just a hunch, you know? Gotcha. Oh my god.
Go, Galaxy.
Come on, Monarch. We're free range now. Come on,
Really could use an A-10 right about now, to be honest. I'll do my best.
Monarch, you're locked on.
I'm fine. The shit? No, they're not. Not for long, anyway. I'm fine. Don't worry. Confirm the kills. Yes, awesome. Wow, they have a pretty high level of detail, all things considered. That's a lot of tanks. So that's why our troops are held up. I was wondering what was taking them so long. Those are AA guns, though. Where's our artillery hiding? There you are. Goodbye. Sure is a big-ass desert. Where are we again? Is this what used to be California? Or something like that? So I wasn't paying attention to a tactical map earlier. Good separation. And they may just barely missed him.
Monarch was a shot.
Got you. How many AM lags do I have left? 19? I could handle that. Guns. Shit, that one actually survived a missile shit. A missile hit. Won't survive this one, though. Shit, really? That is a lot of enemies. Take out the big bird first. That's gonna be a pain in the ass otherwise. Dodge that, motherfucker. Oh wait, you can't. What do you mean, high caliber railguns? The fuck is shooting at me now? Oh my god. It's a little bit close.
Update from the Independence Force HQ. All ground forces secure as much encryption and intelligence data as possible. But if we're unable, just torch and burn. All forces, break it down and burn it. Cause as much damage as you can to this place and blow this whole world wide open. Monarch ready to fire.
It's like mini Stonehenges. They are mini Stonehenges, what the hell? I wasn't kidding.
All units, connect to my uplink and I'll call out targets with the fighter's IFF connection. Should make your job easier.
Oh, we're flying way too close to the ground. Speed is dropping. Ow. Ooh, another one of these fat bastards. Hold up. I'm getting choked by my own index cable here. All right, here we go.
Watch
34 missiles left. I gotta conserve ammunition. But I could probably. Haha! Got you. 13 M lags left. Alright. What do we got left? Bunch of satellite dishes over here. Go, baby, go. Awesome. There you are. Fox 2, Fox 2. Okay. What else we got left? I think we cleared most of this area. Oh, there they are. Headlock and fire. Thank you. What? Still alive? Come on. Hard turn and finish him. I got a bad feeling about this. I don't know why, but I feel like something bad's gonna happen. Guess not. Made FFF.
Alright, pick up what you need to get out of here. We can celebrate when we're back at Rose Dower.
Made FFTeen is just that off. Just that overpowered. I think I tried to say save, but my bilingual yet idiot brain mistranslated partida, which can be translated as save, but I write party. Well, either or works, right? Whatever floats your boat.
Since the destruction of the Solana communication relay, the Federation has been disorganized and subject to our own electronic warfare countermeasures. It is because of this, our first conventional victories up and down the front lines are being reported, and the Federation is dealing with losses it hasn't had to deal with in decades. Recently, in order to improve individual unit combat effectiveness, the Federation has been discharging Cascadian manned units and replaced them with soldiers who aren't nationals. Subsequently, many of our once misguided countrymen have defected, providing us with invaluable intel and manpower. Earlier today, one of our patrols caught a group of transports using the cover of an Arctic storm to get unorganized and underpowered Federation units out of Cascadia, probably to regroup and redeploy later. The patrol engaged, and the Federation sent more fighters to cover them. Seeing as these transports represent the bulk of Federation forces who have experience fighting us, we did not want them to regroup, so we sent more reinforcements. Squadron leaders and base commanders on both their side and ours have been escalating force deployment ever since combat began. High-profile squadrons and our forces and theirs are currently present. This snowball effect, however, has inadvertently created, by all accounts, what is turning out to be the most expansive aerial battle in the war thus far, and is steadily falling out of control. We cannot let the Federation have any more of their forces escape and regroup, even if it means the largest furball in history.
Oh my god. This ought to be fun. TLDR. Haha, jets go brrr. Why aren't there any new jets that are available for purchase? How do I buy new new special weapons? What am I going to do with you? gun pod, maybe? I don't even know what a gun pod is, so we're naturally going to try it out. Right here, buddy. Right here. Oh my god. Now this is Ace Combat. That's the point. Oh my god. That was like right in front of my face too. What the shit? What the hell is the gun? What is a gun pod? I don't know how to use this weapon. Oh! Oh, that's what a gun pod is. It's literally just a gun. Okay. I love this music too, what the shit? Ah, shit. There's too many missiles, I can't avoid them all. Not just one, several. You're mine now! Come over here, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Got you. Hard lock. Box two, box two, box two. I don't know what those are. No!
Hey,
Got you. Man, I fucking love this game. Holy shit, this is insane. Out of flares? Eat missiles. Nice. Oh, yes. Only 8 of these left. Need to conserve ammo now. Damn. Help! Flares, 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 flares. Got you. Who's left? Who's left? Come on, come on. Got you. I lost track of how many kills I've gotten so far. There's way too many guys here. Got you. Oh, the music stopped. That's not good. Great.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit is right. Shit. I am out of MLAs. Oh my god, this crap, this guy I'm fighting right now is pulling G's. My neck is starting to strain. Oh my god. Stay on target. Stay on target. Where did you go? What the shit? We're running out of ammunition. Oh my god, I actually managed to kill one of them. Really wish I had more missiles.
Thank you.
Got another one. Shit, really? One more. Fuck me.
How in God's name are we not dead?
I don't know, diplomat. Man, you have never been able to do this in any previous combat simulator. Looking around with a literal headset at...
Full fury of Federation air power was unleashed today over the Bering Strait. And miraculously, thanks to the actions of the Hitman team, we have not only survived it, but bested it. The Federation's force projection capabilities will be heavily decreased now that their air support across the theater has been effectively decimated at the moment. It'll take some time for them to shore up more pilots from their vassal states, but for now, we have the total advantage. All that remains for them, then, is their airships. But we're drafting up a plan to deal with them now. Until your next orders, get some rest, and expect a little bonus. We couldn't get an exact count of how many fighters you downed today, but we'll just round up and call it fair.
Lots. The answer is lots. Lots and lots and lots of fighters. Fuck me, I am tired.
Hitman team, an interesting hit came up on available taskings, and I don't think anyone else from Sicario's pilots or the other Merc teams could take this on, so listen up.
Independence Force victories countrywide have cascaded into each other. The Federation, now having lost a great deal of its air forces, are falling back. As their front lines fall, however, activity from the more unknown elements of the Federation here in Cascadia have started to stir. Several fishermen within the last week have reported intense bursts of light emanating from the Harkema Industrial Park off the coast. This rig is part of a naval-based private ownership property, leased out to several international companies, including a firm called Icarus Armories. The Federation has recently deployed their own defenses to the rig, and, on top of that, it's manned by private security forces. Your objective is to wipe out any Federation presence on the facility, providing a distraction for Sicario's SOF to uncover what they're doing. Ronin will be clearing some of the radar buoys, giving you a way into the airspace undetected. When you make it through, be prepared for anything. We have no idea what else might be being worked on out there.
This is the mission, I guess, that gets spooky. But honestly, I'm beat. For those of you new to the stream, typically stream for around 3 hours or so. My NX controller is about to fucking is about to die on me. Yeah, he did just say fuck everything and do a fucking 90-degree turn. A simulator cabin would be great, and imagine if it was one of those that actually rolled around in real life. Oh my god. Ah, fuck though. I got to relax for now. It's late. It's the weekend. I just played one of the most intense dogfighter simulators missions ever. I think it's a good point to take a break on. Let me go check really quick who is online right now, and let's raid someone tonight. While I'm checking, if y'all have any ideas for someone you would like us to raid, feel free to drop it in the chat box and I will check while I'm doing so. Kita is a stream? Kita is stream? I have no idea what Okita is, but let's see what the... Kita is streamed. There's a lot of Kitas. Which one are you talking about? Let's see. I don't know who to send you guys to. I guess we're gonna go, we can either go to, well, there's too many VTubers here I could visit. We're gonna visit, once again, someone that, my neck hurts, actually. We're gonna go ahead and send you guys to a VTuber named Ayastar. She is drawing some OCs. New person that I followed just recently. I don't see anyone else here that's doing any flight simulators, so unfortunately I can't send you all to someone that's streaming the same thing, but hopefully this will be a nice change of pace, right? So, without further ado, let's go over there really quick. I think you're the only one left, Christian. Unfortunately. That's how it goes sometimes, I guess. Thank you for coming. I'll see you next time.